live. I am your host, Vanessa, along with my co-host, Sabrina. Sabrina, say hello.
Hello.
Oh. I almost tripped. Okay, so it is Wednesday. Welcome, everybody. Today, we're going to be talking about some of the past fights, some of the fights coming up, of course. We will be speaking with Invicta's Irene Aldana, Alexa Grasso, and Veronica Rothenhausler. I apologize. But we will be joined with them. Actually, the first two ladies, they will be joining us pretty early in the show because, you know, they got training and everything going on. But, so... Oh, no, Jay's in the chat room. The first one, the only one. Okay, so before we get to that, Sabrina, how are you doing? How is your Wednesday going?
It's going good. I'm a little tired, a little sore. It hurt a little bit. But I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. I, too, am in a little bit of pain. I did not do MMA training, of course, but I did this aqua fit class, and that guy, he is no joke, and I think he likes to go a little harder on me, so I was, like, feeling that as soon as I was finished.
Well, that's cool. A good workout is a good workout.
Yes, it was pretty nice. And it is a beautiful day over here in California, lucky us. Hello to everybody in the chat room so far. We got Jay and Roger. Let's see. As I said, we're going to be joined pretty early on by Irene and Alexa because they got some training to do. So, of course, we're more than happy to do that. Actually, you know who our translator will be for us today. Do you?
Huh?
I said, do you know who's going to be translating for us today?
No.
Our very own Gemini Snow.
Oh, nice.
Yes, yes, yes. So hopefully she'll call in a few minutes before, so of course we can just say hello. I don't want to take up all her time, but I'm sure she wouldn't mind hanging around talking to us after. Yes, yes, yes. So.
You wouldn't think, you know, that it would be so hard to find someone to translate for us, but it is.
Yeah, yeah, it really was. But, of course, my sister, Feminine Mista, was on to help me out. That's amazing. I'm excited for today's show because we were supposed to have Alexa on before and it didn't go through, and now we have Irene and Veronica on with us too, so I'm excited, and Gemini is going to join us, and we got some news going down.
Yeah, a little bit.
News. Before we get to news, of course, we'll talk about the fight this weekend, UFC Fight Night 47 in Maine. Mm-hmm. It was Sarah McMahon versus Lauren Murphy. Sarah McMahon defeated Lauren Murphy at split decision win, if I'm correct. That improves McMahon to 8-1. Murphy, that's her first loss. That evens them out. They're both 8-1. On five-round radio, Lauren Murphy, she was just on there yesterday, and she was talking about the moment after the fight, how she thought she had won, and she had asked her coach, like, did I win that fight? And he was like, I don't know, you know, all that time on the ground, I don't think so. And I was like, dang, like, I know she spent some time on the ground, I get that, but she was putting in work the whole time. Like, I definitely thought that Lauren was going to win that fight, you know, even though it wasn't, I think you actually had brought it up the last time we talked about if it went to the ground or whatever, or if, I don't remember. What was it they said? Do you remember what you had said?
If she was going to wrestle, that it would just be like a more of a GSP game, probably.
Yeah. So...
I'm getting really good at calling these fights, guys. I want you guys to know. I should enter like a MMA fantasy thing.
You should. They have some.
I know. Hey, but fantasy football is coming up. I got my draft on Sunday. I can't. It's so hard. I'm about to be stressed out for a few months, so I don't know if I can do both.
That's funny.
I mean, yeah, she lost. That sucks. She did more, but it's just, I think everybody knows how the judges see things. And especially when they don't go to those places a lot, the whole ground thing is going to count more for some. Because, yeah, men didn't do nothing. Murphy did a lot. But I thought that Murphy could have got up, though. She didn't, like... I was telling you, like, I'm no expert or anything, but I thought, she wasn't trained to pummel. She wasn't, I saw a couple times where she had a little bit of space where maybe she could have done a little bit, a sweep or something, but that's just me. So I don't know. And I'm sure she's trying. I know that sometimes you don't see everything when you're in there, but yeah, it just sucks that that ended up being that kind of fight. I mean, they did stand for a little bit in it, but I just felt like they were saying how Murphy was, weary of the takedown, so she wasn't really throwing. But I think I saw that she was very slow. She wasn't, she was, like, hesitant to pull the trigger. And that kind of sucked because I think that if she would have just thrown and not cared, I mean, she already got taken down, for a long time, that maybe she could have hit her with a lot more cleaner and better shots than she did. But whatever.
No, I get what you're saying. You know, I thought it was going to be a different kind of fight, and that's not really where it went. It wasn't, to say, the most exciting fight, you know, but still, in the end, like, I still believe that Murphy put in some more work, but, you know, maybe it was those takedowns. I don't know. I don't know how they choose to judge it. You know, I can't hear and be like, oh, well, I had this, a score of this, because I wouldn't know what the hell I'm talking about. But, the simple fact, okay, Murphy was laying on the bottom, but McMahon was just laying on the top. So, you know, like, nothing was happening, and at least Lauren Murphy was throwing punches while she was down there, you know? So I thought that's what was going to give her the upper hand at the end. I don't know.
It's just sometimes just weird judging because, I mean, yeah, you would think that because you hit her so many times and stuff, but it's just Sarah looks like she's in a more dominant position, and that's what they see the whole fight.
Yeah.
You know, so especially if they can't even see those punches being thrown because where they're sitting. I think they have screens now, but you know what I mean? Like, just when someone's on top, they just automatically kind of get that extra nudge.
Oh, shit. Oh, sorry. yeah, I seen that. Oh, I totally forgot to put that down, where Lauren Murphy had, like, didn't she drop or something on the rankings?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
I think Jay said, same here, she outstruck McMahon big time, and she was dropped from the top 10. I mean...
Those rankings are kind of shitty, though. They don't really, like, count for anything, I don't think. I mean, everybody knows that, like... I don't know. I wouldn't worry too much about that. I mean, it sucks, because then, yeah, like, on paper, it's harder for you to get back to the spot, but... Also, in a lot of these divisions, one or two really nice wins, you'll be right there, you'll back again anyway, so.
Yeah, that's true. Well, you know, I'm excited to see Lauren, Oh, yeah. I'm excited to see Lauren Murphy fight again. I want to see her in a fight. You know,
yeah.
I don't want to see them on the ground. I want to see her in a fight because that's what she wants to do. So,
I mean, yeah. But, I mean, you still have to learn how to stop downs and get
I know
out
you
of
have to
bottom.
Learn how to. Yeah, no, I get that, you know, but there's, I get that there's other parts to the sport,
mm-hmm.
you know, it's not just standing up and boxing or something like that, but I mean, you know, sometimes it's just more exciting than watching people sit on the floor,
yeah.
stay on the floor, you know, I get that you still need to know that aspect. That's why it's called mixed martial arts.
Yeah.
But you know what? She will, you know, it doesn't matter at this point. It's a loss, you know,
yeah.
she'll learn from it, you know, and she'll, I have no doubt she'll come back and she's going to do good next time around. She's not going to let it get, you know, she's not going to let it get away from her. She's going to try and stop it and not let it go.
Oh, definitely. I think that's the good thing about that fight. You know, she lost, but she's going to learn so much from that with, like, with the wrestling, like, integrating wrestling into her game and learning to defend and even take down. So she's going to definitely want to work on that more. So it's just only going to add to her game. So you lose, but sometimes you win when you lose, too.
Yeah.
I like that shirt she wears from Wayne's, bro.
Oh, yeah, you know, I know she's wearing a pretty cool shirt at weigh-ins. I mean, I don't know if you know this.
I know
that.
What
is
your
nice
guy?
It's something like that, something about being live.
That's funny.
We need shirts like that.
Heck yeah, those things are awesome. I'd be down for that. So, let's see, what time? Gemini should be calling us in shortly, and then we'll get Irene online. So, we're going to do that. We'll get into some more news after we talk to a couple of the ladies. Later on at the end of the show, we will be joined by Veronica. So, should be calling in soon. But yeah, UFC Fight Night 47. McMahon defeats Lauren Murphy, split decision. Done and done.
I think she's like, Sarah's men's gonna need to change her game, I think, up a little bit. Cause, yeah, people might be able, not be able to stop her, but I mean, there's still nothing that I saw that would do anything for Rousey. Rousey's not gonna be, I don't think Rousey's, I'm sure Rousey's not impressed with that fight and doesn't have anything to worry about right now. If anybody, so I think she needs to step up. Like, her striking wasn't that bad, too, when they did stand up. I just think she needs to, like, mix it up more than just being a wrestler. I mean, I get it because it gets you wins, but I don't know. But that whole, like, use your wrestling, obviously, but then use it and then do something with it instead of just, like, laying there.
Exactly. You know, like, if that's your game, there should be more to it. You know, like, you don't just get into the starting position and then wait. You know, like,
yeah.
I was looking for something to happen, you know. Hey, I was going for Murphy, but, like, I said both, as for, you know, like, they're both good fighters. So
mm-hmm.
I guess I just expected more out of McMahon as well. In that fight.
I mean, for me, it kind of sucks, but it makes, you know, I'm not excited to see who she fights next, you know, because even if she would have done a good ground and pound, I would have been excited with that, even if it was boring, but when she did win, it was because of the end, she ended up getting where she wanted to get and ground and pounding her out, but it wasn't like that, it was just like, you know, for me, that's not a fight, it's more like a competition, and I don't want to watch fights, so for me, it's kind of, she's boring to me. Because that's what most of her fights, she just wrestles everybody.
Yeah. I got you. Well, it looks like Gemini just came to the chat room. So we will work on that right now. It's going to be fun. Let's see. friends and your friends. I'm trying to find something anyways. But I, Wednesday, we got a few really good girls coming on. After this, we're only going to be like a few ladies away from completing, speaking to all the girls going into Invicta SC 8. That's pretty cool. It would be awesome to get everybody on. Hopefully we can, definitely working on that, trust me. So
I think that's cool. I'm excited because it's only not that far away too. We're almost done with all the girls on the list, which is cool. I think we're going to get them hopefully right in time before they get to fight.
Yeah, that would definitely be awesome. That's what I'm hoping for, but we'll see how it goes. Oh, sorry, one sec. Let me see if she's calling in. I believe so. Hello.
Well, hello.
Hi.
How you ladies doing?
We're good. How are you doing?
Hello. I'm doing okay. I'm like flustered because I know my Spanish is going to like have people laughing. So I'm excited.
It should be fun. I'm just happy that you're able to, you know, help us out. Well, we'll see, but have faith in you.
I'm channeling. I'm channeling my inner Cuban, so hopefully it helps out.
I don't blame you. I'm nervous, and I don't even have to try and do it. Another
girl, thing. It'll be just fine.
Okay. So while I just have to try and connect with Irene, and we will be speaking with her first, and then after we'll go ahead and call Alexa. You know, get both the ladies going because they have training. You're more than welcome to stay around, chit chat with us about some, you know, upcoming news if you have some time or if you'd like.
Awesome.
So I'm going to try and connect with Irene, but maybe you can give us your input. Did you see UFC Fight Night 47, McMahon and Murphy?
Yeah. Let's rehash my heartbreak.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Oh, no. It was like, I think it was a really exciting fight. I'm kind of with the majority when I think that Lauren had the majority of, you know, the numbers on that one. I thought she was going to get it, but, you know, when it comes to judges, I really do think that if you're on top the majority of the time, they're going to give it to you. So I don't feel like Lauren lost their fight. I feel that it kind of proved that she does belong in the UFC, and I just can't wait to see her back on there again. I can't wait to see who they put her up against.
Definitely. That's what I was saying. I'm excited, even though this didn't, you know, go the way that we had hoped or she had hoped. Like, she did really good. I'm excited to see her get back in there and actually fight.
Oh, yeah. Oh, definitely. I can't wait. I think they're going to put her back as soon as possible because, you know, I think the fans really took a liking to her. Her story is one to really be, you know, kind of like, I'm taken aback by her story, just a simple fact of how she came to MMA, how she overcame so much in her life, and then to, you know, go from Invicta to UFC. I think that's going to really make sure that they bring her back.
Yeah, I mean, come on, she was the champion of it at Invicta. I mean, she was undefeated, so I have no doubt. You know,
oh,
she definitely needs another chance. It's not like she, you know, got her ass beat or anything. Like, she went in there and she put on a fight.
Definitely.
She did more from the bottom than what most people do.
I'll be back later. Talk real quick.
Are you? I'm not even going to lie. Like, it's not that I didn't feel like watching the rest of the fights, but I only got to tune in to the last fight of the main card. And, oh, wow, like, I was really surprised that Lauren's and Sarah's fight was so much better than the main fight. Sorry, guys.
Oh, man, that fight. The first couple rounds were all right, but after that, the card was pretty good. There was finishes. That was the last one was pretty much the only one, and it was kind of, they have a little bit of a snooze fest.
Hey, I'm going to definitely have to go back on Fight Pass and watch that one because I didn't go lie. I was so tired that day. I just stayed up for Lauren and woke up just in time to see the last couple rounds of the last fight. And I was like, man, I missed it. I mean, I thought I was going to make it, but, you know.
Yeah, it was all right. That, but all the other ones were cool, though. Who was it? A couple people got knocked out. Someone got submitted.
Oh, man, I forgot.
I forgot who was on that card, and I just watched
it. You know, it was so long ago. Don't you understand? Like, after a game time, unless I have a refresher course on anything that I did, I probably don't remember much.
Right?
So.
I'm with you. I think Tim Boach knocked out Brad Tavares.
Oh, no way.
Nice. Yeah, it was nice.
Ooh,
Tavares was
really
good,
took a
too. I know, I like Brad Tavares. But
yeah.
I guess Boach is from Maine, where they were, so that was cool for him, I guess.
Oh, yeah. I mean, most of the fights on that card really were kind of good matchups anyways. It's not like a one-sided
mm-hmm.
one, like in some. But the UFC fight nights in itself have been so really, like, exciting the last couple ones. I mean, at least in my opinion,
mm-hmm.
that it seems like UFC is really stepping it up, and they're not making one-sided matches, really. I mean, for the most part. You are going to have a couple here and there that are going to slip through, but I think they're doing pretty good.
Yeah, but there's one on Saturday, Dos Anjos versus Benson Henderson. So, I mean, they're throwing in some good people for these.
Oh, yeah.
Not whatever, but fights for a lot of people to see. So, I'm excited for that fight.
I mean, if you think about it, they have Invicta 8 coming up. And I'm sorry, if anybody knows me, they know how biased I can kind of a little bit be towards Invicta. Like, they never disappoint. So how could
yeah.
you not step your game up in the UFC with your fight cards when you know you're about to have an Invicta card on your network? Like, you're going to have
mm-hmm.
to.
Yeah. They do consistently put on great shows.
Yeah. Yeah, they do. They're fight.
True. Are you excited for the Ultimate Fighter? That's next month, too.
Oh, man, you have no idea. Every time I see one of those little teasers, I'm like, I think I just need to stop watching teasers. The more I watch the teasers, the more I get excited. Like, is it not September yet, people? Come on.
almost. Yeah, I hope it's exciting, you know? Like, usually they hype things up, and then you get disappointed. But I'm really hoping this isn't a disappointment. I'm sure it won't be.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's going to really bring a lot of new MMA fans to, not just Invicta, but I think it's going to open the eyes to a lot of people that kind of have, like, that, oh, I don't think females should fight and blah, blah, mm-hmm. and there's not enough talent. And they're going to be quite surprised. I think that this is going to open their eyes, you know, not to mention adding to already the excitement of the people that love Invicta already, because there's some females that we're just now starting to hear of that we haven't seen before, and they're coming with, like, such an intensity, I guess because they know
mm-hmm.
that this is the time to shine, that this next card is going to be so killer. I know it. I feel it.
Yeah, and the exciting thing is the fights are going to be some of the best ones because they're all already, like, high-level fighters. It's not just, you know, one-to-know girls or something. They're all really good fighters, so I'm excited.
True. I'm right there with you. I'm going to try to contain it because, you know, it doesn't – you know, it doesn't look good for a 34-year-old to be so excited about a fight card, but, you know.
Not even. I'd be excited until, I hope I'm excited until I'm old. That's wrong with, like, fights.
I'm going to be shaking my cane at the TV talking
really?
About, let's go.
Telling the young ones when I was young, Ronda Rousey was,
Yeah, I told my age. I can do that. I told my age. So I was a little jit when I was watching, like, the first UFC card. And I was, like, just sitting. I was like, man, I want to do that. And I couldn't because, you know, girls weren't allowed back then. So I could just imagine the kids, like, my age now that are watching Ronda and watching, you know, girls like, you know, Rose and all these other good fighters coming out now. And they're like, man, I want to do that. So it's kind of cool to see that now.
Yeah. And that's the cool thing, yeah, it's like the little girls who see it now, like they can actually go do it. So
yeah.
Wait till we are old and all those girl fighters are even way better than the girls that are in here now.
Exactly. I mean, it's such a – I love to see it. I mean, martial arts is a passion of mine. Like, But to see that now the girls are coming up, and it's not just knowing a little Taekwondo and then getting into Jiu-Jitsu. Now, like, these girls get to go into these MMA gyms, and they're learning all these different styles all at one time. And it's amazing to see the girls right next to the guys, the young ones, and they're doing just as much, if not better, than, you know, than the guys. And you didn't see that.
Yeah, it's awesome. Can't wait till it's just crazy, skilled women. I don't know, it's going to happen even more.
Exactly. Like, it's not going to even be a gender problem. I can't wait for that day when it's not like, oh, women MMA this, oh, men's MMA. It's going to be, man, did you see that MMA card? And it's going to be full of both. It's not going to be a gender thing, which is, that's the day I'm waiting for. And I think it's going to happen soon enough. It just, it takes people to open their eyes to the talent and not the gender.
Yeah, definitely, because there's a girl out there that's going to be, like, Pettis, and there's a girl out there that's going to be, like, you know, Henderson, and just wait, there's going to be those girls throwing those kicks and the same thing.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I know it's not the same sport, but it happened in basketball. We have girls like Brittany coming up there and, like, they dunking.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah.
It'll happen.
Brittany Gunn. Oh, let's see what else. Vanessa's still trying. She's having problems with her calling card that she bought.
All those calling cards, man. Those. Let me tell you, they can get you. I got family members trying to call Cuba sometimes, and when I tell you they start throwing stuff, that's when you know they're trying to use a calling card.
Well, I think you got it, guys. Yeah, all right. I think she's going to be coming in here to introduce you guys into this real quick. Dallin. Yeah, are you excited for this? You're kind of shining right now.
All right, look. That's just hope she understands me, and I don't sound like a complete ass. Nah, it'll be cool. We'll teach her a little Spanglish at the same time.
Right.
All right.
There you go. We all learned today.
Right.
She's going to be coming on just 1 second.
All right. Hi. Can you hear me over? Okay. Hi, Irene. This is, I have Gemini with me. She's going to translate for us.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, I'm
okay.
¿Cómo estás?
Irene, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh,
I can hear really good.
Oh, you can't really hear right now?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. All right, Gemini. We'll go ahead and get started. Thank you so much for joining. I didn't find any amateur record for you. Was your first fight at the professional level?
Do you want me to just speak in English or Spanish?
Irene?
She wants to know if you want to do it in English or in Spanish.
Oh, it's up to her.
Okay, lo que quiera, Irene. Si quiere hacerlo en español, yo lo traduzco lo mejor posible que yo pueda hacerlo. Si quieres hacerlo en español, yo te lo puedo traducir.
Okay, gracias. La respuesta a tu pregunta es, si así es, no tengo peleas amateur. En ese entonces no había mucha competencia de mujeres en México. Y estuve mucho tiempo entrenando fuerte. Estudiamos a la contrincante. Y me sentí preparada para mi primera pelea profesional.
Okay, déjame ver. What she said is she didn't have any amateur fights before her professional debut because in Mexico there's really not a lot of female fighters to compete against. So because of that, she just trained as hard as possible for her professional debut.
Okay, I see. Sorry, I'm a little... When did you first get into mixed martial? What was it that caught your eye that made you want to fight?
Okay, la adrenalina. encontré muy interesante la manera en que se unían las distintas artes marciales en un solo deporte. Eso fue lo que me llamó la atención y decidí probarlo y desde ahí me enamoré del deporte.
She said she really enjoyed the fact that, you know, in MMA, it's more than just one martial arts and one sport. So she kind of enjoyed the fact that she can, you know, learn it all in just one sport in itself, and that's what kind of brought her to MMA.
Okay, and what has your support system been like? Have your friends and family been pretty supportive of you when they found out you wanted to fight?
He tenido el apoyo de mi familia y de mis amigos al 100% todo el tiempo. Al principio fue difícil para mi familia, pero cuando fueron entendiendo mejor el deporte, les encantó y ahora son mis fans número uno.
Qué bueno. She said that, you know, her family is very supportive. At the beginning, it was a little bit difficult for them to understand, but now that they kind of understand the sport a little better, they're pretty much her number one fan.
Aw, that's amazing. Well, I know you're training at Lobo Gym in Mexico. What has it been like training at that gym, and how are you feeling at this point in your fight camp?
Me encanta mi gimnasio. Adoro a mi equipo. Ha sido un equipo excelente. Tenemos un muy buen nivel de maestros aquí en México y este campamento ha sido uno de los más duros y productivos que he tenido en mi carrera desde que empecé.
Okay, she says that she adores her camp, she loves her gym, she says they have pretty much the best teachers, and this has been her hardest training camp to date, yet she's learned probably the most and she's probably the most ready from this training camp in itself.
That's great. I know all of your fights ended with a knockout. How do you feel going into the fight against Peggy Morgan, whose fights have all went to decision? How do you hope to see this fight ending?
Realmente no estoy buscando una manera específica de ganar. Depende de dónde nos lleve la pelea. Voy preparada física y mentalmente para ganar. Espero que sea una pelea que el público disfrute más que nada.
She says she's really not looking for any specific way of, you know, this fight going. She's pretty much going to wait, you know, to see where the fight takes her. And, you know, she's just waiting for it to be an exciting fight for the fans in itself.
Sure, it will be. You defeated both Floor and Myra, I believe it's Floor Sands and Myra Arce with the knockout at Extreme Combat 21. What was it like for you fighting back-to-back like that on the same day?
Fue muy emocionante. Fue un logro personal y profesional muy grande. Al inicio de mi carrera me preparé muy bien y obtuvimos muy buenos resultados gracias al esfuerzo que le pusimos.
She said it was really emotional. She was really prepared and, you know, she's really thankful for... usted dijo los sponsors que tuvo, ¿verdad? And, you know, she's really thankful for the sponsors that she had leading up to the fight. That, you know, it was really emotional and probably one of the biggest ones that she's had.
Your first pro fight was in 2012 against Sandra Del Rincon. How did it feel to step into the cage and fight for the first time ever?
Estaba un poco nerviosa, pero con mucha confianza. Fue muy emocionante experimentar el estar en la jaula por primera vez. Tenía muchas ganas de saber qué se sentía. Y desde la primera vez que estuve ahí, decidí que ese era mi lugar y quería seguir creciendo en este deporte.
She pretty much said it was really emotional. She went in there kind of nervous, but real confident. She just wanted to know what it would feel like, you know, for her first fight and what it would be like. But after her first fight, she knew that this is where she belonged and this would be the sport for her.
That's amazing. Well, by the time you get to Invicta SCA, it will have been 9 months since you fought. How excited were you when you found out that you would be fighting for Invicta?
Estuve muy, muy, muy emocionada. De verdad, la noticia, realmente lo estábamos esperando. Estamos muy contentos de formar parte de una empresa como Invicta. Estoy cumpliendo una de mis metas más importantes de mi vida y entusiasmada por la experiencia de que voy a adquirir como peleadora profesional. Y el honor que voy a tener de estar junto con peleadoras de tamaño nivel.
Okay, she pretty much said, you know, as can it be expected, she was really, really emotional. They had been waiting for a long time for this, for her to come over to Invicta. She's really excited to be part of, you know, such an amazing promotion like Invicta Fighting Championships. It's the most important fight that she's had to date, and she, you know, it's an honor for her to be amongst all the fighters, you know, the wonderful fighters at Invicta in itself. So really emotional.
I'm sure, and I'm excited for you. Everybody's really excited to see this fight, so it definitely seems like a big deal. With the exception of your last fight in Brazil, all of your fights have been in Mexico. How do you feel about traveling to Kansas City for this fight?
Nunca he viajado a Kansas, entonces estoy contenta y estoy feliz de conocer más ciudades nuevas, de tener la experiencia de competir en Estados Unidos. Va a ser una buena experiencia.
It's going to be a great experience. She's never been to Kansas, so she's really excited to, you know, kind of visit and see what it's like in Kansas. And it's going to be really exciting for her to fight in the United States. So she's excited.
Great. Well, with Invicta, with IFAA just a few weeks away, how often do you find yourself over at Lobo Gym training?
Perdón, no entendí la pregunta.
Okay, que tan solo unas semanas de distancia, ¿con qué frecuencia usted se encuentra en el entrenamiento del gimnasio?
¿Cómo ha sido el entrenamiento en el gimnasio? Perdón, no te escuché.
Sí, no, perdón. Como ya no queda mucho tiempo para la pelea, que nada más
okay.
Que quedan unas cuantas semanas.
Ajá.
¿Y quieres saber que,
¿sí?
cómo, que cuánto, qué frecuencia tienes ustedes que vaya al gimnasio a entrenar?
Entrenamos una hora de acondicionamiento físico por la mañana. A mediodía entrenamos 3 horas de MMA y por la noche otras 2 horas también de MMA. Son 3 veces al día.
Son 3 veces al día. She fights, she actually trains every day. Y son todos los días, ¿verdad, Irene? And it's an hour in the morning. No importa. It's an hour in the morning, and she does, like, pretty much conditioning in the morning time. She does 3 hours in the middle of the day of MMA, and then another 3 hours later on at night of MMA. So pretty much it's like a 7-hour regimen on a daily basis.
Wow.
Todo el día.
That's amazing. Well, I mean, what do you like to do when you're not training? I mean, I don't know if you have time, but when you're not training or fighting, do you have any hobbies or anything you like to do?
Sí, me gusta mucho cuando no estoy entrenando, pero más que nada descansar, disfrutar de mi casa, de mis mascotas, jugar un buen videojuego. Me gustan los videojuegos, jugar, ver una buena película, pasear, ir a cenar a algún lugar rico con compañía de mis amigos, de mi familia. Y dedicarle un tiempo al diseño y a la fotografía, cuando hay tiempo.
Wow. Well, she likes to rest on her time off whenever she can. But on top of resting, she likes to spend time. She has pets. She likes to play video games. She watches movies, but mainly spending a lot of time with her friends and family. And I think photography was something that she said in there that she liked to do when she has the time for it, so... She seems to try to stick a lot of there in there on her time off.
That's awesome. Well, I know your pro record stands at 3-1. All of your wins have been by way of knockout, and all of them in round one. Who would you say has been your toughest opponent so far?
Mi contrincante más fuerte hasta ahorita ha sido Larissa Pacheco en Jungle Fights. Larissa es una gran peleadora, muy fuerte. Desafortunadamente me invitaron a esa pelea con 15 días de anticipación en un momento donde yo estaba de vacaciones. No me alcanzó el tiempo para preparar bien mi condición física. Y para el segundo round yo ya sentía mis piernas muy cansadas. Pero estoy muy orgullosa, estoy muy contenta de haberme enfrentado a una contrincante de tan buen nivel y sería muy, muy emocionante volvernos a enfrentar.
Bueno. She says that Pacheco was her greatest and strongest of opponents. Unfortunately, she only had 15 days before the fight as far as to get trained up, and she was on vacation when she got that fight in 15 days notice. So she says that she did what, you know, of course what she could, but she's very proud that she had got the opportunity to take that fight, but definitely that was her most strongest opponent. But she is very proud of taking that fight, though.
That's awesome. Definitely not something to be ashamed of. I can imagine getting in there in 15 days.
It would be a great spread if we can do it again.
That's awesome. Well, I know you're training, and I'm sorry it took so long for me to call you. I don't want to keep you too much longer. I was supposed to call you a while ago. I apologize. But thank you so much for taking the time to talk to me. Before I let you go, do you want to let your fans know where they can find you, if you're on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, and if you'd like to give any shout-outs to anybody?
Yes, Twitter. Mi Twitter es Irene Aldana R. Mi Facebook me pueden encontrar como Irene Aldana medio página. Y en mi Instagram como Irene Aldana R también.
Okay, as far as on her Twitter, it's the same as her Instagram. It would be Irene Aldana R, at Irene Aldana R, and the same as Irene Aldana on Facebook, without the R.
Yeah. All right. Mm-hmm. I thank you again for taking time out. I'm sorry, did you – I don't know if – yeah. Oh, sorry. Thank you again. I don't want to keep you from your practice, so definitely thank you for joining us. I hope we could talk to you again, and good luck at Invicta SCA. I look forward to seeing you on there, and I know a lot of other people do too.
Muchas gracias a ustedes por su invitación, y una disculpa por el inglés. Vamos a tratar de mejorarlo para las próximas entrevistas.
No, está bien. Pretty much thank you for having her on. She says she apologizes for not, you know, the Spanish and English, you know, going back and forth.
Oh, no.
She hopes to learn a little bit better. Pero, con honor, muchísimas gracias, Irene, por la oportunidad de hablar por hoy. Muchas gracias.
Gracias a ustedes.
Thank you so much. You have a good one.
Buenas noches.
Buenas noches.
Bye.
You have 7 cents remaining. Your balance is low. To recharge your card, please stop by the nearest...
Hello?
Hello.
I don't know if you guys heard that on that. I'm sorry. I tried to be fast like a cat. I'm not good at this. I can't... I got like 10 things going on. But I'm just happy that we got Irene on here. And you did it, Gemini.
Let me tell you, living back here in Miami is actually helping a little bit, so I got to thank all the Cubans out there for helping me with my Spanish. It's helping.
We're going to be joined very, very shortly. I'm just going to need a couple minutes. Sorry for everybody listening in if it took a little while to connect to her. I'm not used to this calling internationally, so... I apologize for not being too prepared. However, okay, well, I do this, and you guys are here while we have Gemini, and we can keep her for a second. Where did my stuff go? That story, there was that fight this weekend at Cage Warriors, and Catherine Costa again defeated Noelia Molina, I guess by submission in round one. But the girl is, Molina, she's walking back after the fight, and I guess some fans are saying some stuff to her. I can only assume because she looks over there and jumps over the fence, tries to attack the fan.
What?
Yes. Okay, I'm gonna work on getting Alex on the line. Sister, can you?
Yeah.
I'll be right back.
Yeah, fill me in. Wow.
Yeah, I mean, the one video that we found wasn't completely great, but she's walking, and it kind of does look like someone might have said something to her, and all of a sudden she just hops over the little barrier and goes after him. Can't see that in the video. I hope someone else put the better video up. But yeah, it was crazy. I was like, whoa.
Oh, my. Now, see, this is the thing. I mean, I can't say that I would have had a different reaction. I probably would have jumped on somebody's back to have a better, like, angle at getting to whoever said something to me. But, I mean, that's the sad case, that somebody is willing to pay money to go to an event and holler some obscenities or whatever it is that might have pissed her off to get her to get to that point. I mean, this girl had just gone in there and had a fight. To come out of the cage and to do some stuff like that and have to defend herself by whatever. I mean, regardless if people think that she was in the right or the wrong, the way she conducted herself, I mean, that kind of goes out the window. The fact that there's somebody in the crowd that decides that they have the right to tell somebody something negatively to get them that upset that would make them kind of jump over and kind of leap into the, you know, the fans, that that's craziness. I mean,
It is crazy. I mean, you have to, like, I mean, people are going to just be mean to you. You know, you have to expect some part of that, even if you're awesome, even if you're the one, they probably would talk some crap to her. Yeah, it's crazy. Like, who knows what was said, even if it was something that bad. But, I mean, obviously, like, most people, I've never seen someone jump over the fence to attack, or a barrier to attack someone after a fight.
That's,
I just want to see better videos so I can, like, hear what was said, or actually see, because I don't, like, the person, I don't know, you can't see that well to see if, like, they hit him or what. You just see two people hop over real quick, and I don't know if the other person was hopping over to, like, stop her, but it kind of seemed like they did it at the same time. She just points, and then they both just hop over real quick. Like, I don't know.
Unreal.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I'm trying to get back into the chat because I think Wombat's, I think, is it, let's see, on MRS column. It was an Irish crowd, really? So this was an all-Irish crowd. I mean, was there like a, does anybody know if there was like a difference with somebody from there? Maybe it was like a hometown crowd, maybe?
No, I don't know anything about, like, is there something?
I'm like, I'm all into,
I'm all into the chat.
It's crazy. It's like, I'm really going to have to look it up.
Yeah. You should. We only found one video. Hopefully there's another video somewhere out there. Maybe even just some audio. But yeah. I think it's a little while behind that video, too, so. More people upload that. Are you gonna watch the fight weekend?
Which one?
It is. Oh no, I wrote it down. Well, it's gonna. I don't know if you are, because it's at like 6 in the morning.
Because it's on
Bisping versus Lee.
I want to. I mean, I really do want to. I mean, when is it, on Saturday?
Yeah. Yes. Saturday 6. So 3. Well, depending on what. Well, it's 3:30 Pacific time, 6:30 Eastern time in the morning. So Elizabeth Phillips versus Milana Judiva, something like that.
I really want to. I mean, I know I got to work from 6 to something. Watch me be, like, in there sneaking stuff. Like, what am I doing? I'm working. I'm working really hard watching the fight on my phone.
That's why I'm working. I've never seen them fight, but Elizabeth Phillips is 4-2 in Ilana's 10-3. She's from Russia. Phillips is from Washington. I don't know. I know. Should be exciting. Hopefully, it's the first fight on the card, so maybe you can sneak that one in.
I'm gonna have to sneak it in, man.
Yeah. Vanessa's still trying. You know, she's still trying to get the other girl on the line.
Yeah, it can't be easy trying to get these. Like, not overseas, but, like, international-type calls, man. I've only had to make a couple calls to Cuba, and that was a long time ago when I actually still had family there. So it's like, wow.
You'd think it'd be easier these days.
Yeah. it's like a hop, skip, and a jump away, but, you know, you can't get a ring over there. It's these calling cards, they make it difficult. Like, they ask you for your shoe size, your sock size.
I've never had to use one, so I don't know.
Man, I used them all the time just to call within the United States when I was in the military, and it was a pain. It was like you have to dial this and press down for this, and it's never like a human you're talking to. It's always these automated things.
Of course. It's always makes it so difficult. Man, that's the only fight. There's two fight cards this weekend, but that's the only girl fight.
Mm-hmm. I'm looking forward to there being more balanced fights.
Yeah. I know that I heard that Paige Van Zandt got hurt, so I don't know if they're going to find Caitlin Curran another opponent, but maybe it doesn't seem like Lauren Murphy got hurt. I think they're 135.
In the fast one?
If she wants a quick turnaround. Huh?
You said Lauren got hurt, what, on this last fight that just happened with Sarah?
No, I'm saying I don't think she got hurt, so maybe if she wants a quick turnaround,
That's a good idea.
Right? Why not? I don't remember when this fight is, but I know it's coming up, so. I have a whole bunch of different papers here. I think maybe that would be a good replacement, because I think Van Zandt hurt her back. And that's also the reason why she hasn't been at Team Elf now.
That's never good. Back issues are never, never, ever good, especially in something like MMA, man. That's got to suck.
Yeah, hopefully she was healed right. She's still pretty young, right? She's only 20, so hopefully, but yeah, back then.
She's a baby. You're talking to a 34-year-old. That's baby talk. That's baby.
Well, that's why hopefully, she'll take the time to let it heal instead of being a young kid who's like, I'm good. And then
Put me in, coach. Put me in. Oh, heal, girl. Heal.
Yeah. When I was a kid, I was like that, so.
That's why I'm walking around with a limp here and there, because I was like, you can't do it. Watch me. Like, you can't play football with the boys. Watch me. Bam, got a broken ankle. Here we go. You can't do that. Yes, I can. Why? Because I'm a girl. Watch me do it. Come back with a split in the side of my head. I did it, but now I'm seeing double. So, yeah.
Are you at all excited for maybe this awesome 145 division in Bellator?
What? Are you serious? Like, I think they did the right thing by getting, like, rid of the women at the time that they did. Mm-hmm. Because they wasn't paying attention to them, and it was hurting the females that were part of their crew. But I think now that they see that if they concentrate a little bit more on the women, there's something to gain. I mean, with all these promotions, it's mainly money that they're after. I hate to say that because that's the way it kind of appears to me. But I think they know that there's money in it. And at the same time that there's money in it, it's going to bring a little bit more attention to the females. And as well, it's going to let more females come out there and show what they're about, which in the long run, everybody wants a payout from the UFC. Nobody wants to do this for peanuts. So obviously you want to get to Invicta, you want to get to UFC, you want to make it to where you know that you're going to be seen. Yes, Bellator is a good, promotion. It's been around for a very long time, but they have a lot of ground to make up because, in my opinion, they almost started to make a mockery at MMA. It almost started to look like a mix between WWE and MMA, and it was more of a show than it was about the sport. And if you're into that, that's awesome. You know, I love it. It's great for the entertainment, but if you're passionate about the sport, then you know that you don't want to see that happen to the sport because it's already tough enough to deal with these people out there trying to bash the sport. So I hope that they can get it together and they can, kind of reel it back in and make it more about the sport than the show and the fireworks and all that stuff. And if they do that with the help of the females, Bellator can really get up there with Invicta and get up there with UFC. And obviously I'm going to keep saying Invicta because I think Invicta, supremely tops. But that's just me.
Well, that's a good thing I think about Bajon being gone. I think Scott Coker is great for women's MMA, so I'm excited that he's over there running Bellator, and it's going to be a completely different, an awesome organization, and the women are going to be treated, I think, well. He treats them pretty well. He was always great in Strikeforce, so I'm excited. And I'm excited to see some 145 girls. Coogan got signed, Julia Buss.
Another thing that Cyborg is not interested. She really wants to make that 135, and she's looking to fight on the next Invicta card. I know that Gina Carano is not really interested, but I there's still definitely girls out there that can help make a good division. Like I said, Coker has no problem bringing girls in from all around the world, so I think that's cool too. Like, a lot of other girls are going to get some exposure.
Absolutely. I think this is going to actually, the fact that there's certain names up there that you brought up, like, you know, Carano and Cyborg, mm-hmm. you know, you've got Julia Butt. You've got other females mm-hmm. that are coming out of the woodwork. Like, this is what the sport needs. It needs for people mm-hmm. to stop paying attention to the same handful of names, and it needs to mm-hmm. start allowing other females to kind of, like, show that talent to where they can't mm-hmm. just say, oh, because of Gina, oh, because of Cyborg, oh, because of, you know, Rhonda. No, we need yeah. to see more names. We need to be able to, you know, show some light on other females so that it's not always the same three names. Because that's what's hurting mm-hmm. the sport for the females, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's way too much talent out there to throw around the same two or three names, you know what I'm saying?
Hold on one second. Huh. Okay, we're back. Sorry, Vanessa's still trying to figure out who, it's too complicated. Huh? What? Yeah, I'm excited. And I can't wait. I can't wait till they finally do it. Like, I can't wait. Since all the people that are signed right now, Julia, Bud, and Kunin, can't wait. Maybe, I'm sure they're probably going to fight each other. So, can't wait till they put that.
That'll be sick.
Yeah, it will. You know, people, like, it's crazy. There's so many good women out there that sometimes don't get the attention they deserve. But, man, once you guys, they finally get this platform, you guys are going to see them, and it's going to be so awesome. It's, yeah, Rousey's going to be in there, but you're going to have a lot of people that you guys know more of.
Right. Right. I don't know. There's a lot to be excited about within this year, and there's still so many months left to see what happens
mm-hmm.
next. Like, even if there's not fight cards after, you know, IFC 8, which I highly doubt, I'm sure they're going to bring a heck of a lot more. You know, I think they're having another
yeah.
which is going to be spectacular. But at this point, just to know that the females are kind of like catching steam and they're actually getting that headlining type, you know, attention that mm-hmm. they deserve, it just gives me a lot more to look forward to. Because at this point, if 2014 is this exciting and we're in August, I know that 2015 is going to be just that much more fabulous. I mean, I can't believe it just said fabulous. Oh, God. I'm still not doing well.
And the cool thing is there are so many UFC fights that if they just throw a whole bunch of, at least, I mean, I want them to obviously be good girl fights. I don't want them just to throw fights on there just because, but there could be a girl fight on every card. So
yeah.
I'm excited.
Yeah. I know that I ask a lot of the UFC sometimes, you know. I've even had a tweet from Dana White because I told him a long time ago, I know this guy, right? Like, I'm sending him tweets like mm-hmm. I know this guy. You know, and I sent him tweets talking about, you know, one day he'll eventually admit that he was wrong and that there was enough talent mm-hmm. in, you know, within the females and stuff. And he says, no, I wasn't wrong. I said, all right, guy, respect you, you know, it's cool enough, you know. But we're seeing that females do have what it takes to kind of take over a fight card. And what I'm hoping to see is not just one female fight on a card when it comes to UFC. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm picking at UFC right now because that's what we're talking about. But in any mm-hmm. promotion, you think you're really going to do that good of a thing by putting just one female fight? Put three or four. Put more female fights than male fights and watch the response that you're going to get from the fans. Just watch. You know, do it
yeah.
one time, and if it doesn't get the response and the money that you're asking for, then I get it. Then you tried, you gave it your best, but quit saying that it's not going to do good and not try it out. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
try it out. I guarantee you people are going to be like, hell yeah, like, give me some more females. That's why I think Tough 20 is actually, you know, going to show them, okay, you know what, we got to do this more often. We got to go out there and
yeah.
we got to go around the world and find more females.
Yeah, I hope that's what happens.
Hey, guys. So sorry.
Hi.
I'm having no luck. It makes me so sad. I don't know why I am having so much trouble getting a hold of Alexa. I'm just not having any luck with her. Hopefully we can try. Well, what are we at? We're running on the 20th. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, time to get them. Man, that's a bummer. I really wanted to talk to her, and it upsets me that I'm having so much trouble doing so. Thank you guys, though, for sticking that out.
Boy, I felt like I was back on the block just talking about, you know, MMA.
Well, okay. So everybody listening, I apologize. Alexa, she, you know, may not come on again. I don't know why we have so much trouble. But while we do have Gemini here, who we are so grateful of her for lending us her translating services, you just announced your show is going to be coming out actually this Friday, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. It is called Cage Dreams with Pride. Comes out Friday, the 22nd, at 7 p.m. Eastern. I'm excited, man. It's been a long time coming. I've had this in the plans and the works. You know, we've been working with MMA Jam for a while, and I'm excited because it's a different kind of show. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's nothing better than any other show. It's nothing worse than any other show. It's just different. These fighters don't get a lot of respect. You respect maybe one or two out of like 100 because, you know, they're pretty or because, you know, they had that one knockout that everybody liked, but you never really actually get to know these fighters behind the scenes. You don't get to know what their childhood was like, you know, why they fight. You don't get to know how they were bullied. Like, there's so much to a fighter that we just don't know about. So I'm hoping that they can come on the show and they can come in there with pride and open up and be honest so that the MMA fans can, for once and for all, learn these fighters truly and say, you know what, I may not have understood them before, but, you know, bam, you know, you heard about how they grew up, so you kind of understand why they look a certain way or why they act a certain way or, you know, just for example. I'm going to put myself out there. Before I had this show and before I had my prior show, I couldn't understand why Ronda Rousey was the way she was. I didn't understand why she did all the arm bars and why she couldn't try something different. So I was very judgmental. As open-minded as I thought I was very judgmental. And I had a show, and I had Marina Shafir was my first guest. She opened my eyes to why Ronda was the way she was. I kind of opened my eyes to, hey, you know what? You're really prejudging this chick without even knowing her. You don't know what she's about. You don't know all the struggles she went through, why she's so cocky, why she's out there, you know, hollering. So I felt maybe a show about fighters' pride and their stories would kind of bring a little light into the MMA community, you know, lighten it up a little bit. Kind of like what you would see on the Ellen show. You know, laugh a little bit, cry a little bit. You know, something
definitely
to get these fighters out there. You know what I'm saying? Like, you never know. These fighters need sponsors. These fighters need fans. These fighters need tweets. You know, they need everything, but it's up to us. So why not? Let's put a show out there. And I couldn't do it without you guys. You know, you guys are always supportive of anything that I do. So I want to thank you guys for even letting me announce it on here. So I love y'all.
Oh, no, I was so excited, and I love the idea. I definitely think these fighters are constantly under the eye of somebody, you know. So with your show, it kind of gives them a spot to be open and free and just be themselves and not, you know. Hopefully people will be willing to just open up and, you know, talk about their story and give us a little better idea of who they are as people. Because I totally get what you're saying with Ronda Rousey. Like, at first, I had a certain impression of her, too, you know, in the way she acted. And then once we met her, it was like, oh, well, you know, like, no, now it makes sense. Like, you know, she's not mean or,
exactly.
You know, it's crazy. So I really like that idea.
Yeah, Well, I appreciate it. I hope that, you know, I hope people are open to it. You know, and needless to say, I'm very open about my lifestyle. I'm very open about myself in general out here in social, you know, media, because, you know, I'm a goofball. It doesn't matter to me, you know, what people know about me, because, you know, I'm like, I am who I am. So the fact that it gives maybe people an opportunity to say, hey, look, you know what, I'm with so-and-so. I live a certain way. You know, I am who I am. And not feel that the host will kind of like be kind of attacked, you know, or attack them, or be very judgmental. And, you know, I just want somewhere where they can go and say, hey, you know what, me and my wife are about to, like, go train. And it's not like a, oh, she said wife. It shouldn't matter. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I know not everybody's going to agree. I even had discussions on here with different fighters about their own views. You know, and we've come to a mutual, respectful understanding of where people stand. And I feel that if we can do that amongst everybody, including fans, I think that, you know, it can be a better community. I mean, we've got to support each other. And sometimes I feel like we kind of bash each other in a sense. And I think that's why I'm so grateful that I'm part of the MMA Jam family, because I think that we do a pretty decent job at supporting each other, man. Like, we kind of really have some genuine love for each other, if we can say that. You know what I'm saying? Like, we do care about each other. We kind of put each other out there and support each other. So, no, no, I feel like it's going to be a good thing, you know? And I appreciate y'all.
Definitely. I'm excited. And I'm excited that, like, I don't have to wait forever. It's just in a couple days. That's it.
I'm excited. I mean, we have Tanya Evinger and Stephanie Alba on as our first guest. So I'm super stoked. I don't know what's going to come out of their mouths, and that's the fun part.
I know. Especially Tanya Evinger, so that's awesome that she's one of your first guests.
Yeah, I'm stoked, man. Like, they've actually known about me having a show for a while, and the second they found out, they were super cool about it, and they were like, hell yeah, you know, just let me know what's up, and I'm super grateful. I mean, she's going to be on soon enough at Invicta, SV8, so I'm so ready to hear what she's got to say, because that fight between India Gomes and her, oh, man, that's going to be one for, the history books right there. I know it.
That's how I feel about that one, too. I'm excited for that fight, and I freaking love Tanya Evinger. She's so funny. I remember I had texted her before the show to be like, oh, you know, just a friendly reminder, and she didn't get it till like the day after, and I like wake up to this text. It's like, I didn't get this until after the show, but now I have your number. Wah-ha-ha-ha. It was the funniest shit ever. She's so hilarious. So I look forward to hearing that.
It's gonna be a fun-loving show, man. Like, y'all know me by now. If I haven't made y'all laugh yet, then I'm not doing my job. I'm a goofball. I done seen so much drama in my own lifetime that I think at this point, with whatever years I have left on this earth, I just want to make people laugh. I want to make people smile. And, you know, like, this is just one way of doing it. You know what I'm saying? Like, a simple conversation about, hey, you know, why did you get into MMA? And when you have folks like Tanya coming on and Stephanie, I mean, you just don't know what you're going to hear that day. So, you know, you be ready for some kind of excitement and entertainment, you know, kind of like tune in there, buddy, because it's going to be off the chain.
I have no doubt. I'm super excited. Again, I'm so bummed we didn't get to talk to Alexa again. I don't know why. I have so much bad luck getting her on the line. They don't want us to talk to each other. Let's see. All right. But thank you so much, sister, for doing that for me. And at least for the most part, you didn't have to do a lot of speaking Spanish.
Yeah, I mean, it kind of cut off half of it, so that extra nervousness about having to translate it to where she can understand it, you got that for me. So you know what? You did it for me. That was it. I appreciate that.
That is so funny. Well, let's see. We, in about 10 minutes, I believe, we will be joined by Veronica Rothenhausler. am I saying it right? Either of you?
Oh, okay. I am the one to trash every single name, including my own. So,
okay.
You know, I just, it sounded good. I mean, to me, it sounded good. But, you know, I'm sure once they get on, they usually say, no, it's kind of like this, and this is how you say my name. I'm like, oh, cool. Thanks. You know, I know for next time.
I know, right?
Sometimes the funny thing about that is they know how to say their name really good. So they say it, and then you're like, wait, what? And then you still fucking sing it.
Are you talking to me?
No. The thing is, I went and watched them call fights, so I'm like, no, I'm going to say this person's name right. And I go and I watch it, and then I say it just the way the person announces it, and nope. That's not the way you say it.
Like, I even put in homework to
say
it.
I should have just
right.
Watched it and just waited for them to correct me.
Right. That is so hilarious. I was trying to get a hold of Alessa, so I didn't really get to hear what you guys are talking about. I think I missed out on everything.
We can't go back.
Man. Did you not talk about anything? No, you guys talked about Cyborg, Toronto.
Talked about 25. We talked about maybe Storm Murphy replacing Paige VanZant. Because why not?
Ooh. She said, ooh.
I like that.
I know. I don't know why Joe Silva has the job. Just call me, guys.
You said, why not? I'm ready to go, like, right now.
I got it.
Did we also already welcome Mark to the team? Mark from Wombat Sports. He will be joining MMAJam.ca and helping us here and there with some articles. Like, seriously, that is the spot to go to. Wombat Sports has everything as far as women's combat sports, because it's not even just MMA, it's WMMA, boxing, kickboxing. You go there, he has like amateur pro fights listed, the results, like he doesn't play around.
I get 90%, if not 95% of the females that I have followed on Twitter, I've gotten from Mark's site, because he's so honest, and it's like you can tell he really cares about what he does. He cares about these females, and, you know, you can just sense that from somebody, from just looking at the way that they write, from just looking at the dedication on the site itself, and it's super exciting to see that he's part of the team now. That's amazing. Hi, Mark.
Hi, Mark. I know. He is in the chat room. Welcome to the team. It is definitely an honor because, yeah, I definitely go there for my news. I mean, where else? You know, there's that number one source, and, like, when you're looking for it all, that's the place to go. So,
yeah, definitely. I'm
excited to have him on here. I actually already did one a piece for MMAJam.ca. I don't know if you guys had a chance to take a look at it yet.
I'm definitely going to have to do all that reading on this weekend when I'm actually off a day, because I get home too pooped to read.
Yeah, no, I don't blame you, but it was really awesome. It was actually called, like, Beauty in the Fight Game. And, you know, it talks about, you know, because that seems to be a big thing these days, you know, like people can't believe that a woman would be fighting, or maybe some people think the pretty girls are getting ahead, or, you know, like they don't want to believe that these girls just like to friggin' fight each other. Like, it doesn't matter if they're beautiful or Miss America quality or anything like that. And it's a really good short little piece, and at the end Mark's like, I leave you these two pictures, and so Brittany Elkin, one of them, like a photo shoot, you know, it's all done up and her makeup and her hair and all pretty, and then the other one, it's, I believe it said it was like middle of third round war with LaToya Walker. Man, that was the picture you were showing me. You remember you were showing me the picture of, you were like, dude, look at this picture, and the girl, like, her face was all, like,
oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It was crazy. It was a crazy picture. But, and you see it, yeah, and look, there she is standing in her beautiful dress, this pretty girl, you know, but look at her in the cage, too, you know, it's not, she still has what it takes to be a fighter. Just because she's a pretty girl doesn't mean anything.
I'm taking a look at it now.
Oh, sorry. No. Maybe we all should have taken a look at it.
Everybody's saying, oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that picture? Oh, man. Because when I first seen it, I was like, my goodness, you know, like, she looks like a zombie. Like, there's so much blood. Yeah. And, like, that's, man.
It just proves that, you know, it doesn't even matter. Like, you're definitely going to have, just like in any other sport, you're going to have females that carry themselves one way. You're going to have females that carry themselves a different way. Like, the way that you dress or the way that you look should have absolutely nothing to do with what your talent is once you get into that cage. Like, it shouldn't be about that. Obviously, you're going to have those, excuse the word, turnballs that are going to look at it that way. You know, and you're going to have the opinion of, you know, these numbnuts, to say the least, you know, that all they care about is watching two pretty girls go at it. Like, then you're not there for the sport. And then your opinion to me doesn't matter. If you really don't care about the sport, then you shouldn't even talk about it. If that's why you're watching it, then go watch it. Go find yourself a promotion that's going to give you that. But for those fans that really care about the sport and really understand the sport, I guarantee you it's not going to matter who's in it. As long as they're banging out and they're actually giving you a good fight to watch, they're not going to care. But, you know, it's those weekend keyboard warriors that get behind there, that probably sitting behind their, you know, the keyboards with little whitey tighties on, you know, and got all that crap to say. You know what I'm saying? Like, they got nothing else to do, so they're sitting behind there talking about who looks one way or who looks another way when they probably look a hot mess themselves. So, yeah, they're opinions.
That is so funny. I definitely agree. I mean, look at you, Vina. You're going to be a fighter. Yeah. And look how cool you are.
Yeah.
No. I mean, no matter what, you have to work hard. You have to fight good. You might make it there because of how you look, but that's not why you're going to stay there. So you want to embarrass yourself and not go and take those opportunities when you shouldn't, then go on ahead. But, you know, beauty doesn't matter when you get in that cage. It's how you perform, and that's all people see anyways. No one cares what your face doesn't look that great when you're knocked out or when you're knocking someone out anyway. So.
Yeah.
You know, it's all about that fight anyways.
Yeah, exactly.
I definitely agree with that. Man. So, sorry. I'm just trying to think, because you guys pretty much talked about everything. Was there anything new that we didn't catch? Is there stuff going on in the world? Man. Actually, about a minute.
I know you're trying to get us to start jibber jabbering again, and then you gotta go.
I know. I just realized that. I apologize.
Well,
actually,
I appreciate the opportunity, ladies.
Hey, thank you very much, and I look forward to your show on Friday. I will be listening
awesome.
In. And
I had an awesome time rambling on with you too.
Hey. I mean, I'm down whenever you guys want. You know, I'll be here. I'm long-winded, and, you know, I feel like I have a comedy. So I got the comedy. I got the jokes. I got the goofball sense. So whenever you guys need a hand, you know, I got you.
Awesome. You're awesome. All right, sister. Well, you have a good rest of the week. You rest up. I know you just got home from work. And we talk again soon.
Take care, ladies. It was a pleasure. Mm-hmm. It was awesome. Little brush up on Spanglish, so y'all be good.
Okay. Awesome. All right. Have a good one.
Bye.
All right. Sometimes I feel like you're hanging up with me, and I'm like, where am I going? I think you're just trying to hang up with me. But,
I could hang up with you if I wanted to.
Whatever. Anyways. That's messed up. That's my biggest fear, being left alone. All right, so we are going to be joined by Veronica. Let's just get my stuff together here. Let me give her a call right now. Sister, you look for any news going on?
Nope.
All right, here we go.
I do have her, like, oh, wait, you're going to call. So good.
Oh.
Nope, getting her.
You shut up now. Send that thing. Okay. Well, that didn't not work for me. Man. It seems as we go down the line, we're not having very much luck.
They're just busy. You got to be on point.
I know. Oh. You know, the funny thing is, I'm not even going to lie to you. I had you muted right now. So it's kind of like I was talking to myself.
We thought it had a good jam in there that we missed. You can't replay that.
Trying to get these fighters on the phone. Mm-hmm. They don't want to answer our calls. Gonna call them back, though.
That's all I got, guys.
It's all right. I'll save you. We're gonna call her back right now. Not muted, so don't, like, fart or anything.
Automatic voice message system.
Mm-mm. It almost got me.
Maybe she was calling, trying to call you home.
I don't.
You can't do
it. You can call the. Can call in to talk to the host of Blog Talk Radio.
Was that lady answer? Because that's who I want to talk to.
I'm trying to remember if she answers as a guy with Blog Talk Radio. I think there's a guy.
Name.
I don't want to, like, bug or anything. Oh, shit, already got. Okay, well, while we are. Oh, let me see. At it. So sorry, guys. Just trying to look at some stuff here.
And I'm not a good help sometimes, so you guys know. I just like to sit and watch, and then I forget that I'm on here, too.
That's the funny thing, because, like, I'm trying to figure stuff out, and you're watching me try to figure it out,
mm-hmm.
So we're both quiet.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't work like that. Talk. Blog. Talk. Radio.
I don't understand why you can't do two things at once then. Why can't you talk and try and figure that out?
Have you never met me? I don't
know.
Get it. Because my luck has been going so well. it says she's Veronica's trying to call in, but won't let her call back in. So let's try again. Probably because the brain keeps talking.
Ooh. Hello?
Hello, Veronica.
Hey, sorry about that.
Hey. No, I'm sorry. Tag it. I'm just kidding.
What's going on?
How are you
doing today? I'm doing pretty well. How about you?
I'm doing good. Just relaxing. So nice out right now. I'm in California, so it's like perfect weather right now.
Where are you in California?
In Orange County.
Oh, okay. Right on. Yeah, it's a super nice day on the West Coast, huh?
Yes. I love it. Well, sometimes. Sometimes.
Yeah, right. Sometimes I'm like, you know, I would love a real cold day. I would love to have to wear, you know, some boots and a beanie for once.
Exactly. That's what I'm looking forward to.
Yeah, for real.
Well, I get so sorry for calling you and bugging you over and over. thank you.
No,
so
you're, it's all good.
Chit chat. Go
yeah,
ahead
for
and
sure.
Get right into this. Let's see. Well, first off, when did you take your first ever combat sport class, and what was it about the sport that made you want to give it a shot and take it as far as you have?
I played volleyball and softball from 4 years old all the way throughout college, and so I've always had just the kind of the need to be, I'm an athlete, you know, I need to be around athletics, like I have a need for it. And so once volleyball and softball was done, one of my buddies said, hey, you know, he was a wrestler. He said, hey, I'm going to an MMA class. You know, one of my friends is in there, whatever, whatever. Would you be interested in giving it a shot? So I was like, yeah, for sure. Not really knowing what I was getting myself into, but I figure, hey, you know, I've been in a couple brawls here and there, so let's give it a shot. And so I... went to the class. It was in Reno, just kind of like a small, it was a wrestling, like an industrial building. So it was pretty cool. I really liked the feel to it. It was a Battleborn MMA. And so I went to one of their practices and I remember I hit some guy and, you know, they gave me gloves and everything and I hit some dude and his mouthpiece flew out of his mouth. And I was like, all right, like, I like this, you know? and then kind of ever since, I just fell for it. Yeah, that was a full-on sparring day that I walked into, and I really liked the fact that they could, you know, get down and throw hands at each other, and then right after just be cool and you know, laugh about it. So, yeah, I love it. Can't imagine doing anything else, that's for damn sure.
Well, that's good to hear. I mean, it would be a little crazy to step into the cage like that and be like, I don't know if I want to fight, because I know me.
Yeah, right.
Like, there's no way I'm stepping into that cage. Let's be real. Well, you took your first AMI fight in September of 2011, taking the win from Caitlin Johnson with a TKO in round one. At the High Desert Brawl. How exciting was it to step into a fight for the first time ever and come out with such a strong win?
I was definitely excited to get in there. I've never felt nerves before a fight, just kind of more like anxious, like, all right, let's do this, you know, kind of like more real, you know, before you get into a real fight, it's like you're just like, all right, let's do this shit, not like, oh, what if this, it's like, you can't think that. Hey, what if this happens? What if she, it's like, no, that's not the mindset that I have going into a fight, you know? It's like, all right, I'm about to beat your ass. And so I went in there and just really, I trained for 9 months before I had a fight, since that January before that. So I really felt that I was ready. And, you know, I had a couple smokers and stuff like that, just like a more like low profile bouts, but yeah, I got in there and I just did what, you know, I've been training to do, and I would like to think that I have some natural ability when it comes to fighting, so then training on top of that and just kind of the will to win, you know, took me the distance for it. So it was cool, it was fun to get in there and just kind of reaffirm that this is what, because once I started, I fell head over heels for it, and I was just like, yep, this is what I meant to do. So once I got in there it went the way that it did, I was just like, yep, I knew it. So yeah, here I am today.
Well, in your AMI record, two of your, sorry, let me see, you got all three of your wins in round one with knockout, two of them 5 seconds into the fight, like your last two. One of those five-second knockouts was your last AMI fight in 2012, where you took the win at and tough enough featherweight champ title from Ashley Evans-Smith. I mean, how crazy is that when you think of the fact, like, you just as an amateur, you got two knockouts in 5 seconds. Like, that's insane.
I mean, it definitely, I'm thankful for it because it kind of put me on the map, you know, and that video went viral, and then I'm pretty sure, like, that's how everything went down with Invicta. So, yeah, that was cool, get in there, snatch a belt up, and then, you know, got the call from Invicta. And, I mean, it is cool to have that because not a lot of people can say, oh, yeah, I have a 5-second knockout twice. But I'm excited to get in there and get some serious cage time because, you know, that's important in what we do. And it's different when you're in practice and when you're inspiring than when you're in the actual fight. So I'm excited to get in there with Tweet and kind of play around and, you know, spend a little time in there with her.
Yeah, well, I mean, this isn't your first time under the Invicta banner, but you haven't fought since Invicta 4. That's when you went pro. That was your first fight. You went pro 2013 at Invicta FC 4 against Catalina. There you go. Thank you.
Yeah.
How did it feel to step into the cage at the pro level for a promotion like Invicta, and then to find out you would be fighting at Invicta FC 8?
Yeah, it's crazy how much time has gone by, but, you know, shit happens. I mean, stuff that obviously was not in my control, and the only thing that I can take from that is I wouldn't be given this opportunity to open up the 155-pound division if all of those things didn't happen. So, you know, yeah, they suck, and I wish that I could have done what I initially planned to, but I just have to remember, you know, everything happens for a reason, and now I'm getting this awesome chance, and I just can't wait to, you know, to get out there and do my thing. But as far as my first fight, yeah, Monga, she was tough, man. She had a hard-ass head, I'll tell you that, and she hit pretty freaking hard, too. But I think that, like I said, this is what I'm meant to do, so it wasn't like, wasn't scary or nerve-wracking. It was just like, okay, here I am. This is what I've been training for. This is what I'm supposed to do. So let's do it. And that's, you know, it just feels right. So it's easy to do when it feels right.
Definitely. Well, Invicta FC 8, you're going to be taking on Charmaine Tweet, as you said. She took on a pretty good fight camp in Canada recently, training with your past opponent, Ashley Evans-Smith. How has your training been? I believe so. I could be wrong, but I thought so. how has your training been going so far? I believe you're still at Team Alpha Male, or?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay.
You know,
great team, and
No, it's cool. Yeah, dude, it's been great. Like I said, it's been a year and a half now since I fought, so I've basically been fighting for this or training for this fight for a year and a half, and you know, I'm a completely different animal than I was when I fought Catalina, and I'm just they're the best guys in the world. You know, they're some of the most insane athletes, and they're champions. I mean, we literally have the best guys in the world on my team. Like, to be around that every single day and to learn from these guys, it's like, how could I not get exponentially better, you know? So I, Tweet can do whatever she wants. I really don't think that she has an answer for what I'm about to bring her. So, you know, she's just been totally running her mouth for man, it feels like a year now. So I just let her talk and say whatever she wants, and that's all good, dude. You know, some people, I did say one thing back to her. I said, you know, some people are talkers and some people are walkers, and you're usually never both. And I think that she's a huge talker. So hopefully she can really bring what she's got for September 6th because she's gonna need it. So I'm excited for the fight. This is my, you know, fight that I call my statement fight. I'm going to get out there and make a statement and say, look, here we are. We're, you know, the women's lightweight division. This is where it's at. This is where the knockouts are. This is where you want to, you know, the crazy shit that people want from MMA, that's where you're going to get it, is from the lightweight division. Of course, all the other athletes are always bringing it. But, you know, we've got some more weight behind it. We've got some more size, more power. So I really want to get out there and showcase what we can do with it.
So, well, Charmaine, her record is at 5-4. You know, all five of her wins coming by way of either guillotine or a rear naked choke in round one. How does it feel going into this fight with somebody with more experience professional-wise? And, you know, like, does that worry you at all that she's, you know, chill going in there, like she's done this for a while, or are you like good to go, like that stuff doesn't bother you, like being in the spotlight?
Yeah, no, nothing that Charmaine has worried me. I'm sure, you know, I've seen her compete. Yeah, she's a good athlete. I've also seen her get knocked out in like 20 seconds, so I know how her chin is. And no, I don't think that yeah, I mean, like I said, I'm over with the best wrestlers in the nation, all on my team. I mean, obviously they're not all on my team, but we have Uriah, we have TJ Dillashaw, we have Lance Palmer, Chad Mendez, you know, Joe Benavidez. I have some sick girls over there that, you know, I have Cynthia Cavillo, who is one of the biggest upcoming fighters for, you know, she's a little 125er, and she's a badass, man, and these people are just really putting me to the test, and Charmaine doesn't have what they have. So I'm very excited for this fight because, you know, this is the first time that I've spoken about her because she just always has something to say. So I'm just like, all right, man, put your money where your mouth is. You know, you've been running it long enough, so let's see what you really got.
That's crazy. I didn't realize there was, you know, anything going down. So, but this fight, man, Invicta SDA altogether, everybody's really excited for it. So it's going to be intense all around. Well, as I said before, this isn't your second time fighting under Invicta. How have you liked fighting for Invicta and working with Shannon Knapp and everybody over there?
You know, Shannon's awesome. I really can never say enough good about her. She's always treated me with respect. And, you know, I love the fact that I always say, like, look, Shannon's a boss, you know, because she's not only my boss, but she's a boss, you know. And mm-hmm. she does what she thinks is right and not what the popular vote is. And I think that's really cool. And she really cares about us as athletes and as individuals. And I'm super excited to get in there and fight for them and under them and just put on an awesome show and once again show people that Invicta Fights lightweight division is just bringing it. And, you know, you're not going to want to look away. So I couldn't be happier to be with them. And I think we're both growing with Women's MMA, and it's just a great time to be doing what we're doing.
Well, Mark is in the chat room. Yeah, and he was wondering who would be cornering you for this fight.
I'm bringing out with me Danny Castillo. He's actually a co-main event on the August 30th fight, UFC 177. So he's going to have his fight, here in Sacktown, and then we're going to head out there and do our thing.
That's awesome. That's great. Well, for you, what has been your favorite or most memorable fight so far?
I would say definitely my Tough Enough fight was super cool. You know, to get that belt was awesome. And that was at 145, and, you know, that's a really tough cut for me. So to make the weight and then just get in there and handle it, you know, and then walk out with the belt, that was awesome. That was, it was awesome.
I'm sure you walked out with the title, so that's definitely amazing. What do you like to do when you're not in there training or fighting? Any hobbies, anything you like to do? Or you're always training and fighting?
I know that's kind of, whenever that time is. I have a dog, I have an Australian Shepherd, and I like to go running with him. That's always fun. Good exercise for both of us, and he's super fast, so he keeps me honest on my face. But, I just like, hanging out with good people, I guess, being around people who are interested in doing, interested in succeeding. So.
You said it. I wouldn't have corrected you. I thought you were right.
Yeah, but there's like 30 guys out there right now saying succession. What an asshole.
That's so funny. I've loved talking to you. You're hilarious. And I definitely look forward to seeing your fight at Invicta SC8. I look forward to everybody on that card, and a lot of people are really excited about this. It's just few weeks away, not a couple weeks away. Like, that's insane. How are you feeling right now? Are you like, are the butterflies starting to kick in, or are you like, you just want to get in there ready?
Yeah, I mean, this fight's already happened. If I said 1,000 times, I would be, underestimating, but it's already happened so many times in my head that I'm just ready for it to get here and get out there and do what I want to do, and 2 weeks. So it'll come and go, and then, before you know, we'll be stepping into the cage. So I'm definitely excited, and thank you so much for having me, and let's talk after the fight. And we'll recap.
Definitely. Before I do let you go there, I want to give you a chance to let people know where they can find you on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Also, if you'd like to give any shout outs.
Yeah, for sure. I actually don't have a Facebook. I'm anti-Facebook. I'll put that on record. But you can follow me on Twitter or Instagram at Veronica Fights. Just my name and then Fights at the end, all one word. And then, I definitely want to thank Invicta for this awesome opportunity and Shannon for opening up the lightweight division and letting me fight where I need to be at. And I want to thank everybody at Team Alpha Male, and just the guys and girls over there are just awesome, and it's like, it's so much more than a team. It's like these guys are my family, and then I want to thank my friends and family for putting up with me, because you get a little grumpy cutting weight and all that good stuff, so and just the massive support system that I have is so awesome, and I'm just super thankful for it, and thank you again for having me.
That's awesome. Thank you for taking the time. I know everybody's busy fight just a couple weeks away.
Cool.
So I appreciate you taking the time to talk to me. It's been really fun. Congratulations and good luck at Invicta FCA. And we will definitely talk again and see how things went down and what the future holds for you afterwards.
All right, right on. I'll talk to you soon.
All right. You have a good one, Veronica.
You too. Later.
Bye. All right, you guys. That was Veronica Rothenhausler. Piggy on Charming tweet at Invicta FCA. You can find her on not Facebook, but Instagram and Twitter at Veronica Fight. Sister, are you there?
No.
Oh, I'm very jealous. Mark just. Oh, hold on 1 second. Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Alexa?
Yeah, it's me. I'm sorry. It's a trouble with
Hi.
My phone.
Oh, no. I'm so sorry. I don't know what's going on. Thank you so much for calling, though.
Oh, it's okay.
Well, I know you're over there training, too, so I won't take up too much of your time. I'm going to go ahead and get right into it. So I know it hasn't even been a full 2 years since you took on your first MMA fight. When did you start training for the first time?
Oh, the first time I was training, I was like 15 years. And
oh, wow.
It was because, because I accompanied my uncle to teach in a gym. He was in a class and I was watching the class and he told me, oh, come on, you try it. And I tried.
That's awesome. So you've been doing it for a little while. I mean, what was it about the sport that interested you and made you want to go professional?
Well, many things. I've always played sports, but never found one that suited me. So when I started to train, I realized that it was difficult. I mean, it was too much coordination and air, and many air. It was... And I like to sweat, and this sport can do that. And
yes.
The most beautiful thing about this is, you know, the time in the gym with my teammates. We have a lot of fun, and I found with them a really nice place to share a passion. I think this is a passion because I'm obsessed with this.
That's amazing. Well, you too. I just spoke to Irene. You guys are teammates, and you're both over there in Mexico. All your fights have taken place there as well. What is the fight scene like in Mexico? Is it hard finding other women to fight? And did you have a lot of support when you decided this is what you wanted to do?
Yeah, it's very difficult to find another girl to fight. You know, here in the tournaments, I mean, nationals or just here in my city, there's like, one or two, or maybe when we are like 10, but we are so different weights. So, yeah, it's very difficult. But there are girls. Just, yeah. You know. And we think we have enough support in Mexico because the gyms where I train have a good reputation. And
yeah.
We have been disciplined. I think
yeah.
That's why people is supporting us.
That's awesome. I didn't find any amateur record for you either. Did you go straight into fighting at the professional level?
Yes. I know that's kind of quickly because I had no choice. You know, here aren't many girls, so the ones that had available for me was professional, and my teacher talked it to me. He told me, hey, we have this girl, she's a pro, what do you think? And I was like, oh, damn. Well, she's the only one. I can take it. And so I trained it very hard, and that was a good decision.
Yeah, definitely. you're getting pretty far. You're at Invicta FCA, so that's awesome. Since all your fights and training have taken place in Mexico, how are you feeling about having to travel for this fight?
I feel very excited. I know this is going to be a really beauty trip with all my team, and I'm very, very excited. You know, I would always dream with this day, and, well, with that day.
It's almost here, too. Just a couple weeks away.
Yeah, it's very soon now.
I know. Well, you finished your first three opponents in under 36 seconds. Your opponent, Ashley, she's 3-2 with those losses coming by way of knockout and split decision. How do you feel going into this fight, and where do you see this fight going?
Well, you know, this is MMA. I can say something, but anything can happen. We are very complete fighters, and I think that anything can happen in that fight. So I think it's going to be awesome.
I'm sure. And I know you usually fight at 125 pounds, I think. How are you feeling at this point in your fight camp, especially making the drop to 115 pounds?
Well, to be honest, I miss really much the chocolate and many meals. But I feel really good. My body has changed so much. I feel lighter.
Yeah.
And I have an incredible nutritionist, and it's okay with this. I'm overweight almost.
That's good. And soon you'll be able to eat those chocolates, but almost.
Yes. Well,
your professional record stands at 4-0, with three of those wins coming by way of knockout, one by unanimous decision. Which would you say was your favorite fight for you so far?
I like them all, but certainly the best was the last one, because I had to train very hard. There was a Grand Prix, and there were two opponents. The city had more hate. It was the public against me. It was hard, but once I got in the cage, I forgot everything, and I give my best, you know, I give my best, and I won.
That's amazing. You're going to be going into Invicta SC8 with your teammate, Irene Aldana, who we just spoke to a couple minutes ago. Does it help having a teammate by your side in the gym and making that trip with you?
Yes, I feel more comfortable and secure. Irene and I are almost always together, and share this with her is very nice. Besides being my teammate, she's a really good friend, so this is a great experience for both of us, and I feel really good.
I bet. I'm sure how especially you guys can train there, and then you have to take that trip over there, so you guys are going through it together. Well, speaking about teammates, how has training been going for you over at Lobo's MMA, and how often are you in their training?
I'm here almost every day, afternoons and at night, because I train here twice. And we're a big team, you know, everyone is helping us in our preparation. We have something to learn from everyone, you know. It's an amazing team here.
Yeah, I could only imagine. It seems like you guys are doing pretty good over there. You got a good team. You get to do this together. What do you like to do when you're not in their training?
You won't believe it, but I like to do my homework. You know, I'm studying at morning. So when I get out of the gym, I'm watching videos or, you know, doing homework, and I like that because my mind is really away from punching and brawls and that kind of thing.
Homework. That's good, though. That's a good influence for the young ones listening in. Everybody should enjoy that. The fight, it's just a couple weeks away. I mean, how do you feel right now? How are you feeling today? Are you nervous? Are you good to go? Are you just want to get in there?
Yes, I want to eat chocolate, and I want to fight now. I'm ready, you know, I feel ready, so I want it now. So But I have to wait just to fix some kind of things. But I feel really good now. I want to go to Kansas.
It's going to be a lot of fun. A lot of people are really excited. They're really excited for this fight. And, you know, you're taking on Ashley Cummins, and I believe, Ashley Cummins, Invicta FC8. It's exciting. You know, a lot of people are looking forward to this, and I'm so excited for you. You sound so happy and looking forward to it. Give me one sec. I think Mark wanted to speak to you. I'm just going to check. Sorry. Hello, Mark?
Yeah. I was listening in, but I do have a two quick questions for you, Alexa, if you don't mind. First of all, you're coming in from an MMA background, and actually BJJ, you have a really good BJJ background as well. What did it mean to you to go kind of that direction versus what a lot of your country women are doing in terms of boxing? What was it like for you to kind of go against the grain, as it were?
Oh, I'm sorry. I couldn't understand.
What was it? I'll try to ask it again. You went the MMA route versus going boxing. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
It's okay. I think he just wants to know why did you choose MMA over boxing? Since that's very popular over there.
Because it's not that I choose it. My uncle was teaching MMA, so I learned everything.
That's awesome.
From your uncle, let me try to clarify. From your uncle, you kind of learned a lot of the MMA and stuff like that. Would you consider doing boxing down there, on the side, or are you really just dedicated to MMA and that's it?
Well, I think that Mexico is a good place to learn boxing, and I feel good with that.
Well, okay, that's great to hear. It's great to be able to see that you two, Irene and yourself, are pioneers in terms of, being female MMA fighters from Mexico. We've had quite a few that have had Mexican heritage, but I think you two being pure, simply embedded in the country, as it were, kind of being the forerunners of what we could see as a kind of a trend there as well. What does it mean to you to kind of inspire fighters down in Mexico to try MMA?
Well, I think that Mexico is... I will choose MMA.
I'm sorry?
Or can you repeat me the question?
What does it mean to you to be able to inspire other women in Mexico to maybe try mixed martial arts?
Well, this is very amazing. I feel so good. You know, I have really a lot of messages in my Facebook about girls who are starting to train, and I feel good with that. I feel happy.
Well, I'm going to be happy. I'm going to actually be down there covering the event, Alexa, so I really look forward to meeting you in person. it might be a little bit easier to ask questions when I'm down there, but I really look forward to meeting you and Irene and both of you, because I think both of you are doing so much for the sport right now. I really look forward to it. And the best of luck coming into you, and I will see you in Kansas City.
Oh, thank you so much. And I'm sorry, I couldn't understand.
No
but
problem.
Thank you for the interview. And goodbye.
Irene, thank you so much, Mark, for calling in. And thank you so much, Alexa, for calling in. I know we had a lot of trouble getting a hold of you. Before I let you go, I know everybody wants me to tell you that you need to get a Twitter first. but do you want to tell people where they can find you on Facebook, maybe, and if you want to give any shout-out?
No, I don't have Twitter, but I have Facebook. It's Alexa Grasso. 999.
All right, Austin, did you want to give any shout out to anybody?
I'm sorry, could you repeat it for me?
Oh, would you like to give any shout outs, any thanks to anybody who's been helping you along the way or fans or anything?
Well, I'm very thankful with all my Lobodim team and Samurai FC, to my professors and everyone who has helped me being in this great, great trip.
That's awesome. Thank you so much, Alexa, for joining us. I look forward to your fight. Congratulations and good luck at Invicta FC 8. We will be seeing you in that cage soon, and I look forward to seeing how your fight goes.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
All right.
Have
a good
day.
One. Bye.
Bye.
All right, you guys. And that was Alexa Grasso. We got it
on.
I'm surprised. We did it. She called in. I know, she did a great job talking all on her own, and you guys, I know we went a little late, so we apologize. Sister, thank you very much. Big thanks to Mark for calling in. A big thanks to Gemini for translating, to Jay, to Lauren Murphy for sporting that awesome MMA Jam shirt at UFC Friday Night 47. To everybody in the chat room, everybody listening, it's Wednesday. It's almost over. Enjoy. And we will see you again next week. If you can't wait, tune in Friday for MMA Jam with Izzy. And don't forget to tune in to Gemini's new show. Also, I think it comes on right after MMA Jam. So kick back, relax. We're going to entertain you. Have a good week, everybody. Sister, you have a good one. Good night.